Hello students, in this video lecture series we will discuss all these cases. We will draw shear force diagram and bending moment diagram for each case. In previous video we have solved cantilever beam subjected to a concentrated load at free end, and in this video we will discuss about cantilever beam subjected to uniformly distributed load over entire span. So this is a question. This is a cantilever beam. AB is a cantilever beam on which there is a uniformly distributed load. We are seeing these rings. This is the uniformly distributed load. We will see here. This is the same thing. This is a cantilever beam on which uniformly distributed load is here. So in some books it will be like this, or we can represent in this form also. Both are the same thing. Now we will understand the difference between the point load and the uniformly distributed load. This is a duster, and if I am applying load like this, this is a point load. And if I am applying load like this uniformly on the entire span, this is a uniformly distributed load. Now we will start question. So we can see here that this is a cantilever beam, and on which uniformly distributed load is here, W per unit length. So what we will do, first we will take section. We will take section between A and B. And we are saying it y dash. And the distance of this section from the point A is, or free end, is x. Now we will write equation for the shear force. This is shear force diagram, and equation for the shear force this is a section y dash, and we will see towards the left of this side. So we can see here W is the per unit length. W is weight for per unit length, or for per unit length weight is W. So for x length weight will be W into x, and it is applying downward, so weight will be minus W into x. We will understand once again, this is a section. We will see towards the left of this section, and this is the total force. We know W per unit length is the force. For the unit length, force is W. So for the x length, force will be Wx, and it is applying downward, that's why it will be minus Wx. Now we will find out shear force at x equal to 0. We will slide this section towards this side. So what will happen? X will reduce. It will come here. X will reduce. So at x equal to 0, shear force is 0. Because x is 0, we will keep x 0 in this equation. We will get final value is 0. Now shear force at x equal to L. So what we will do, we will take this section, and we will see towards the left of this section, and I will slide this section to this side. When it will come to this side, so x will be L. So shear force is minus W into L. So at point A, shear force is 0. So at point A, shear force is 0. This is 0. And at x equal to L, shear force is minus WL. This is B and it is minus WL. Now we will see the general equation. General equation is minus WX. It is a linear equation. This is linear. So from A to here we will get a straight line because it is a linear equation. So this is a shear force diagram. Now we will write equation for the bending moment. So we can see here this is a section and we will see towards the left of this section. So the force towards the left of this section is minus WX minus WX into distance. So we are seeing this is the force, this is a uniformly distributed load and we will convert it into the point load. So the point load will act at the mid of this one. So distance will be x by 2. We know bending moment is the force into perpendicular distance. Force into perpendicular distance. So it is x by 2. We will understand it again. Suppose we have a UDL load example, this is example. So we can convert this, suppose this is W per unit length. So and it is x, so we can convert it into the point load. WX AB. We can convert uniformly distributed load into the point load. For this one, W is the W weight per unit length, for x it is WX. So it is acting at the mid of AB. This is a total length, it is acting at the half of this one. Similarly, in this case, minus WX is the this force and we will consider it is into the point load and it is acting here. So, and the distance of this WX from section is x by 2. So this is force minus WX force and x by 2 is the distance from this section and we are assuming this is a point load which is acting at this point and the distance will be x by 2. So this is a bending moment equation. Bending moment at x equal to 0. Now I will remove this one. So we know the bending moment equation. Now this section will slide to this side. So what will happen? X will reduce and the bending moment at x equal to 0 will be 0. We will keep x जीरो. इन दिस इक्वेशन बेंडिंग मूवमेंट इज जीरो. नाउ वी विल स्लाइड दिस सेक्शन टूवर्ड्स दिस साइड. एक्स विल बिकम एल. सो बेंडिंग मूवमेंट एट एक्स इक्वल टू एल. वी विल कीप एक्स एल इन दिस इक्वेशन माइनस डब्ल्यू एल इंटू एल बाय टू माइनस डब्ल्यू माइनस डब्ल्यू एल स्क्वायर बाय टू. So it is bending movement, it is shear force diagram. Bending movement at A is 0, it is 0. Bending movement at x equal to L is minus WL square by 2. माइनस डब्ल्यू एल स्क्वायर बाय टू इट इज पैराबोलिक वेरिएशन. सो वी कैन नॉट ड्रॉ स्ट्रेट लाइन, इट इज पैराबोलिक. सो द ग्राफ विल बी लाइक दिस. So it is a bending movement diagram. Suppose a student has doubt that it should be like this or it should come like this. So what we can do, we can use a local method. We will use this equation and we will put points from x equal to 0 to L. We will get the data points. Otherwise, you can see from this, this is a parabolic variation. We can draw like this. So we will discuss here. So this is a bending movement equation, which is a parabolic variation. So what we can do, we will put the points. This is x and this is bending moment equation. At x equal to 0, bending moment 0. At x equal to 0.2 L, bending moment W by 2 L square into 0.04. X equal to 0.4 L, bending moment is W by 2 L square into 0.16. X equal to 0.6 L minus W by 2 L square into 0.36 0.8 L minus W by 2 L square into 0.64 and X equal to L minus W by 2 L square. So we are increasing the length of So we are increasing the value of x like this. So at this point it is 0. We will get all these points here, and at x equal to L, we will get this value. So we can also draw in this way so that we can get the curvature of a bending moment diagram. So this was about the cantilever subjected to uniformly distributed load over an entire span. In next video, we will solve cantilever subjected to uniformly varying load over entire span. Thank you.